Hey guys, we are live Tuesday for the live session at 3. Last week I was terribly sick, and this week we are back in action, back at the office, and back in the game. So guys, today we are answering a few questions that I got throughout the week on social media, and one of them are, what should I invest in? Albert, I have a little bit of money, what should I invest in? And the other one is, Albert, how do I stay encouraged on this journey as an entrepreneur when I experience failure, when I see failure, how do I stay encouraged? So the two questions is, what do I invest in? And the second one is, how do I stay encouraged? And if you have any other questions, post them on the live feed, on the session, and we will answer them live. So guys, gonna be a great session today. Juan, JC, Shalandri, Orlo, thank you so much for joining in. We are excited about today. We're gonna talk about what should I invest in, what should I do with my money that I make, and how do I stay encouraged. But first, a little bit of news for the week. If you haven't bought your ticket to How to Entrepreneur yet, you should do it immediately. We are having an event the 7th of June in Pretoria, in Menlo Park. It's going to be about How to Entrepreneur. There's going to be four speakers, Gabriel Kleiman, Franco Leibrand, myself, and Marnus Broederijk. And we're going to talk about how to entrepreneur, how to become a great entrepreneur, how to improve your current business, and how to become an all-round entrepreneur in terms of confidence, mindset, and business basics. So please make sure to get your How to Entrepreneur ticket. And then some more news, we're finishing this week with our 6 Zeros to a Million course at Hartier's John Forster. We took a lot of the students through a course called 6 Zeros to a Million that we wrote in terms of getting the financial mindset right and changing their perception on finance and money and wealth. So it went great. The students are very happy about the course, very encouraged, and I see a lot of change in their lives. So that's the news for the week. And now to the topics of the hour. We're gonna talk about how should I invest, what should I do with my money, and how do I stay encouraged throughout the week, throughout my journey, and to stay on top of it. But if you have any other questions, send them through and we will talk about it live. Juan, JC, Shalandri, Orlo, and Jonathan, Johnny, thanks for joining in, and we will talk about it. So, Albert, what do I do with my money? I've been making a little bit of money. How can I invest it? Where should I invest? What should I do? So there's a lot of different options. Mainly, I would suggest three different options. So the first option is to invest in yourself. What do you mean by investing in yourself? I make a lot of videos where I talk about different types of investing, what you can do, and one of the ones I always mention is invest in yourself. What do you mean by that? It can be to actually invest in a skill. To invest in yourself as a skill that you can later sell. So let's say you are giving beginner guitar lessons, you're a beginning guitar lessons teacher, a beginner, whatever, and you give guitar lessons to beginners. You can only make a certain amount of money with that lessons that you charge, a certain hourly rate that you can charge. But if you invest in your skills, if you say, look, I'm gonna improve, I'm gonna do this Trinity course, this grade 6 exam, I'm gonna improve my skill, then you can always charge a higher rate for that same guitar lessons. So in that way, you invest in yourself to improve your skill in order to charge a higher rate. Similarly, if you want to invest in studying a degree or a course like an industrial engineer, or get an IT degree, or get a certain certification that can actually increase your income, you can invest in that. If your business, for example, needs a certain certification, a certain skill level, then you can do that. You can get that certification and increase your skill level in order to increase your income. So the first thing that you can invest in is yourself in terms of your skill. Invest in yourself, up your skill, up your game, so that you can charge a higher rate and generate more income. You can also invest in yourself in terms of a financial mindset. So you can do a few courses, you can get a mentor, you can read books, you can buy books, buy courses, or pay a mentor to mentor you on a monthly basis that up your game. Just for that, you know, investing in yourself to increase your efficiency, to increase your result, to increase your success rate. And that way you generate more income by investing in yourself. Does that make sense, guys? If it's making sense, if it's good value, just send the shop on the live feed and then I know I'm on the right track. We're talking a bit about what you can invest in if you have a little bit of money on hand. Just to check everyone out, John, JC, Shalandri, Aura, Jonathan, Annemarie, Bertus, Pierre, Arnu, thanks for joining into the live session. If you have any questions, send them through and we will answer them live. So the first thing you can invest in is yourself as a skill or as knowledge base to increase your income. What's the second thing you can invest in? You can literally invest in a business. Okay, so let's say you have a coffee stand at a rugby game on the weekend. You sell a few coffees. You have your kettle, your little table there, and you're selling coffees, right? Now you're making a bit of money. What can I invest in? Either you can invest, like we said, in yourself as a skill, up your game, get a barista certificate or whatever, so you can charge more, work at high events, or you can actually invest in the physical business. Okay, so you can say, hey, maybe I can buy more cups. Maybe I can buy a higher grade coffee. Maybe I can buy an automatic coffee machine. Maybe I can buy a trailer that I can actually drive to rugby games and then sell coffees in the morning and have it there as a stand. Maybe I can invest in another employee to kind of help me out at games so that I can maybe go to another game. And then as you invest in your business, you keep on growing your business. You get your first coffee cart. Then you get your first machine. Now if the money comes in, you buy another machine. You buy another coffee cart. Then you get an employee to run the second coffee cart at another school, at another rugby or cricket game. And then as you make money, you invest it more in the business. You buy more coffee carts. You buy more machines. You hire more employees. And that way, you can literally make an investment in a business. And a business can have a massive rate of return. I mean, I remember we started Gazaroo in 2015 with 1,500 Rand. That is literally the capital amount that we invested in the business. The other aspect in terms of the investment is the work hours, the effort that you have to put in at the rugby games when you're selling coffee, the early mornings you need to get up. So that goes along with the capital investment in the business. But we started Gazaroo in 2015 with like 1,500 Rand, and at the end of last year we turned over 800,000 Rand in terms of sales worth. So that's just to give you an idea of how a business can grow in terms of that little capital investment and the correct amount of elbow grease. So that's in terms of investing in a business. And then there's the third option, investing in an actual investment. So we said you can invest in yourself as a skill. You can invest in a business in terms of investing more capital in your business and growing your business. And then thirdly, you can invest in an actual investment. And for that, I will suggest go see a financial advisor. They know all of the good investments that's out there. There's a lot of good mixed investments. That is a mixed portfolio in terms of money market, equity, bonds, property, that balances your investment very well. And make sure that when you do invest your money with a financial advisor, make sure that they're accredited and that they're proper and that they're trustworthy. Because you might lose all of your money if you invested with the wrong person. So there's a lot of pitfalls as well, especially with investing in your business as well. You need to have the knowledge. You need to have the financial background. You need to read the books. You need to practice to make your investments worthwhile. So guys, that's on what can I invest in, guys. What can I invest in? You can invest in yourself in terms of skill level. You can invest in a business in terms of capital that you physically put into your business. Or you can invest in a proper investment at a big investment firm or with a financial planner or advisor that you can invest with to create a good mixed investment for you so you can start building capital until you have enough capital to in the end invest in something bigger, invest in a big business or in a lot of property or in a big investment or startup or whatever. Guys, so that's on investment. How's it so far? If you like the live feed so far, if it's valuable to you, send a shop, then I know I'm on the right track. We talked a bit about how can I invest and in what should I invest if I have a little bit capital on my hands. Then the second question for this week is, how do I keep myself encouraged? How do I keep myself going through this journey, and how do I keep myself full of energy and drive? So I talked about this exact point a few weeks back on the live session, but I'll recap quickly. And it's about keeping your current situation connected with your dream. Okay, so your dream is there in the future. That's what's giving you energy. If you think about your dream lifestyle, right? Your dream that you want to achieve, that big thing in your life, you get an excited feeling, right? You feel excited. You get, you know, encouraged. You're like, yes, I can do this. I can go in and do this. And that's the feeling you want every day. And the way to do it is to take that dream and connect it with your daily activities. What am I doing today that gets me closer to that dream? Because a lot of people have the dream, right? They have the dream on this side, and then they have their daily lifestyle on this side, but they do not connect the two. And they go through their daily lifestyle not connecting it with their dream. They think, oh, I'm busy with this, but one day I'll start working on that. And if you can connect the two, if you can say, hey, I'm busy with this, but all of these things that I'm doing now is connected to my dream. Let's say you want to become a public speaker, international public speaker. That's your dream. You want to tour the world and do that. If you're currently a manager at a small business, you can connect the tasks that you do on a daily basis to that dream by saying, hey, I'm working with people. I'm managing people. So I'm learning communication, which is going to be very valuable as a public speaker, as an international speaker. So I'm learning how to communicate, how to speak. You can say, I'm learning management skills, business skills, which is going to be very valuable when I have to talk on those topics as an international public speaker. I'm learning, you know, how to make sales, how to make deals, how to work with money. That's going to be important when you have to book your talks overseas, when you have to travel, make arrangements, that type of thing. So now you can relate the things that you do every day to that dream. And then you're working with purpose. Then everything you do today has a purpose, because you're investing in that dream and you're working towards that dream, and that will give you energy every day. That will keep you encouraged and keep you motivated. So guys, we're having a great live session today. Juan, JC, Shalandri, Oralo, Johnny, Anna-Marie, Bertus, Pierre, Arno, we have Angelica, Johannes, Krishane. Thank you everyone for joining into the live session. We talked today about what should I invest in, what can I invest in if I have a little bit money on my hands, and the second one was what should I do to keep myself encouraged in my daily life, how can I generate energy, how can I stay positive to get to the end destination. I hope it provided a lot of value for you guys today. Keep strong, good luck with your week, and remember to get your tickets for How to Entrepreneur. We have Gabriel Kleiman, Frank Leber, and myself, and Marnus Broederijk in Pretoria. We're going to talk about how to become a great entrepreneur. Cool, guys. Have a great week. See you next week on the live session.